Hello and welcome back to one of James the Great Explorer episodes. And remember the time when I showed you the red cocoon that has hatched into the large yellow underwing moth. And you won't believe what we're doing right now. I'm going to pick it up and let it go. Ready. Steady. Go, 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 go. We have it in my hand right now. Three, two, one, go. Go on.
So what's that called again, that moth?
The large yellow underwing moth.
Mm-hmm. And how does the cocoon look like? Is that the red one?
Yeah, the red one. Mm. It doesn't want to go right now. I don't know what it's doing. Just staring at the camera. Funny way. Yeah, they call it the large yellow underwing moth because it's one of the biggest. Well, of course the biggest would be like big, but the caterpillar is big, so it's cool. Mm. Oh, it's not flying away now. It's getting a bit nervous. I don't know what's gonna...
Okay, maybe just fling it, blow it a little bit.
Okay, I think it's gonna fly now. Oh, I didn't know it could grip. And just to tell you, moths have something, it's not like poison, but a bit like powder stuff. And it doesn't taste very good. So the things that attack it, when they eat it, it doesn't taste very good and it just runs away. So, it's good. I want to get it to fly so you can see how it flies. Don't go on my face, man. Remember, do not put a moth near your face. Butterflies don't have this powder stuff. I don't know if it wants to run away. It's getting a bit like brave. Most moths just fly. Hello? Don't crawl up my sleeve. If you want to, just get back into the ball. I'm not letting you crawl up to my face, okay? I just need you to fly, man, okay? Hello?
Okay, see?
Be brave, let's explore. See you on the next adventure.